Hello and welcome to this first video of the tutorial series in which we develop a simple Pong game with the game engine Godot. I chose Pong because of its simplicity. It is often taken as the first project if you want to gain your first experience in game development. So it is comparable to the classic Hello World, which is available in almost every beginner's book for learning a new programming language. Now I want to show you what the game might look like when it's done. For this I have prepared this example project. You can move the player up and down with the arrow keys, whereas the opponent is moved with a simple AI script. The ball is pushed in a different direction with each kick and makes a different tone when it hits the wall or the racket. As soon as the ball hits one of the goals, the score will get adjusted. Also, both the ball and the rackets are reset to the starting position and another round begins. But enough of the demonstration, let's get to work. In this episode, I want to create and configure the project with you. First, I will move this example project out of the way, and then we can open Godot. What we are seeing now is the project manager of Godot. Because we want to start a new project, we click on New Project on the right side of the window. In the window that is now open, we specify the name of the project and the path in which we want to save it. Of course, you adapt both the name and the path to your needs. I use simple Pong here as the name of my project and use a folder path where I will save this and future tutorial projects. Although we have specified the path and the name for the project, we still have a message that the folder is not empty. So what we have to do now is press the create folder next to the project name. Leave the renderer setting at the default setting and now we can click create. This creates an empty project. First we will change some project settings. To do this we click on project in the top bar and then on project settings. On the left of the setting window the possible settings are divided into categories like application, debug, compression and so on. We want to set the screen size to 1024x512. For this we need the category display. So I scroll down the left side of the window until we see the desired category. Then we click on the subcategory window. On the right side of the window we can now see the possible settings. There we set the width to 1024, what is already done. The height to 512. And remove the hook at resizable. That was all. Now let's close the window again. You can press close at the bottom or use the classic X in the upper right corner. Next we will create a few folders to have a structure in the project and make it easier to find everything afterwards. I will do it with the first folder so you can see how it's done. First right click arrest folder. Now a context menu opens, in which we have various options. Since we want to create a new folder, we click a little further down on New Folder. A pop-up opens where we can enter a name for the folder. The folder I want to create first is called Entities. When you are done typing, click OK. The folder has now been created. In the folder we just created, we store the objects used in the game or in a scene. But all game objects, such as the racket, have their own subfolder, which contains all the required assets. I will now create more folders for the menus, scenes, and user interface. The folder names are chosen relatively self-explanatory, so that you can find everything easier later and thus do not disturb the workflow too much. It is also easier for others who might be involved in the project to find a way around. Of course, you can name the folders as you like and create the structure differently. We have now made all the necessary preparations for a simple further work and thus done everything we wanted to do in this episode. So thank you for watching the video and until the next episode.